Hello everyone, hope you're doing fine. In this video, we're just going to see the bending moment and shear force diagram for various types of beams. So since this is a weekend, I think you guys can relax because all the questions that I have taken is like very, very easy and I'm sure you guys will know most of the answers. I have like 22 questions here and keep a count of how much you are able to answer. Out of 22, comment the answers of how much you are able to tell correctly. So let's get started.
And before we start, I would really appreciate it if you could smash that like button, drop me a comment, and share this free program with anyone who might need it.
So the first beam is a simply supported beam with a point load. So next question, this is also a point load on a simply supported end. So if I look at my shear force diagram, it will be something like this. Say, wait for the harder ones. I have set them for the end. Next, a simply supported beam carrying a UDL. Next question. Next I have a UVL on a simply supported beam. So these intensities are equal to my RA and RB values. Okay, we know that, right? The intensity for a simply supported beam will always have shear force at the end, whereas bending moment will always be zero at the ends. So now, say these are my intensities, I will have a parabola here, that is a curvilinear variation. Next is my bending moment diagram, and bending moment diagram is also going to be a curve. Next question, this is a cantilever beam. So now we have come to cantilever beam subjected to point load. Next question, a cantilever subjected to UDL. Next question, again, a cantilever beam, this time subjected to UVL. Next question, so this is a propped cantilever beam. For shear force diagram, you have to look into the vertical forces. So my vertical force, if this is W and this is L, then this will be WL by 2 and this will also be WL by 2. So you can see both the vertical reactions are same, which means that my shear force, right, it will be, force convention is, this will also have WL by 2 will be my intensity, whereas when I look here from right side, I mean from left side, it is positive, it will be WL by 2, and in between you can see that this varying of load is UDL, I mean it is a UDL. So when UDL comes, our shear force diagram will vary linearly. So our shear force diagram will be something like this. Now coming to bending moment diagram, and this is what we call as the point of counterflexure. Mind you, it will not happen or it will not be present in simply supported beams or cantilever beams. It will be present only in overhanging beams and propped cantilevers and continuous beams. So going to the next question, what is a fixed beam? Fixed beam can be broken into two types. That is a simply supported beam subjected to the given load plus a simply supported beam subjected to the moments. So fixed end beam, what makes the fixed end beam a fixed end beam? If moments are applied to the ends of the simply supported beam, then it is a fixed end beam. So it can be broken into two types. So first let me draw the bending moment diagram for this. So bending moment diagram, I can just individually draw the bending moment diagram for both the things and I can overlap them. So when I overlap them both, let me draw the negative bending moment here. So this is my negative. This part will be nullified. Whereas when I come to my shear force diagram, again, you can just draw the shear force diagram for this and this together. So here you can see there is no vertical forces at all because both the moments are equal. Therefore, we'll not have any vertical reactions in this part of the beam. Therefore, this cannot be taken for shear force calculation. Because for a fixed end beam, the shear force calculation is very easy. Just think that it is a simply supported beam with the given loading condition. Next question. Okay, a fixed end beam carrying a UVL. Next question. Okay, so from now on the difficult question starts. This is a cantilever beam, this is also a cantilever beam. They both are subjected to uniformly varying load. So what will be the difference in the bending moment diagram of these both? So this is the difference between them. Can you see how it is varying? Like, this is also a parabola, this is also a parabola. I'll tell you why they are like this. So when you look at this beam, here you have higher load. So higher load means high slope. Low loads means less slope. Now high loads are concentrated at this part. Therefore, here my slope is more, whereas here my slope is less. Whereas here, when you come to this diagram, you can see my, you know, the loading is very high here, which means my slope is also very high. Whereas when you come to this part, my loading is less and therefore my slope is also less. In the next question. So this is a simply supported beam subjected to moment at one end. So what will be my shear force diagram? So it is always better to find the reactions in a simply supported beam. So you can see that this moment is present. If it had been an another moment here, then this and this would have get cancelled because this would be in the opposite direction. But since it is not present, then I'm pretty sure that I'll have my RB and RA values. Quick tip here. So RA is going to be producing a clockwise moment, whereas M is producing an anti-clockwise moment. So since they are opposite in sign, then I can say that RA is equal to M by L. Whereas since RB is also producing an anticlockwise and M is also an anticlockwise, I can say that RB is equal to minus M by L. So this is your reaction. So from this you can find your shear force diagram. I come to my bending moment diagram. At this point there is no moment at all since it is a simply supported. Therefore I'm going to go for zero. At this point, even though it is a simply supported end, I have a moment. So I'm going to produce that moment here and the variation will be linear. So this is next question. So if that moment had been placed in the middle, so how will be my shear force diagram? This time also my shear force diagram is going to be the same. So RA is going to produce a clockwise. This is also in clockwise. Therefore I can say, since they both are in the same direction, I can say it is minus M by L. And RB, since they are in the opposite direction, anti-clockwise and clockwise, I can say it will be M by L. So from this I can say that my shear force diagram will be negative this time because it was a clockwise moment. Whereas when I come to my bending moment diagram, there is no moment here, there is also no moment here, there's just moment here. So when you look at RA is negative, so RA is in this direction, so RA will produce a negative moment only. If you look at the sign convention, from the right side, clockwise is positive, but RA, right, since it is negative, it will produce a anti-clockwise moment. So your moment will be something like this. It will be negative first, then positive. So most of the times, even I used to get confused. I used to draw it like this, but just make sure what is the, you know, the sign of RA to make sure that you don't make any mistakes. So far, I think you guys are getting every answers correct. If you do, please keep tracking your progress. Let's see how much you're getting. Next question. So this is an equal and opposite moment. So I can say that these moments can cancel out each other for my shear force diagram calculation, which means my RA and RB, they don't exist. It is equal to zero. Therefore, my shear force diagram, I can say it is zero. When I come to my moment, this is just like a fixed end beam. So what are my fixed end moments? It will just be a rectangle. That's it. Now coming to this diagram. This beam, where you can see M1, I have two moments. I have M1 and I have M2, and I can say that M1 is greater than M2. Say this is 5 kN, this is 4. So 5 is greater than 4. Now coming to the shear force calculation, now you'll have your vertical supports, because these two moments, they won't cancel each other though they are in the opposite direction. RA is equal to 1 by L. And RB will be equal to minus 1 by L. Shear force diagram will be present. Unlike this case, you'll have a shear force diagram. Since RA is positive, it is going to be positive. And if you come to my bending moment diagram, you have bending moment at both the ends. So I can say you have bending moment here. So it will be 5 here. And this will be 4 here. And the difference will be linearly varying. Okay, this is a cantilever beam subjected to a UDL at one end alone. So how will be my shear force diagram? So I can say this is my V, and this V will be equal to, if this is W and this is A, V will be equal to W into A. So how will be my shear force diagram? It will be constant till here, and then since this is downward, it will be linearly varying and it will become zero. At a free end, shear force will always be zero. For bending moment diagram, this is producing a clockwise moment. Therefore, it will be negative. So till this part, it will be a parabola like this. Then after this, it will be linearly varying till the fixed depth. Next question. Okay, we have special type of loads here. So I want you to remember that higher the load, higher the slope concept. First, let us look into shear force diagram. Okay, so these both are linearly varying. So we know that for a linearly varying structure, if it had been like this, then my shear force diagram would have been like this. But for this case, my shear force diagram, even for shear force diagram, higher the load, higher will be the slope. So my shear force diagram for this will be something like this. Here you can see my slope is almost zero because here I have low loads. So bending moment diagram has high load here. So higher the load, higher will be the slope. So it will be something like this. The slope becomes less here. Slope will be less. Then it again increases like this. So this will be my bending moment diagram for this kind of beam. Now coming to this my shear force diagram. So here my load is more. Therefore my shear force diagram has to be more there. So this is my shear force diagram over here. So this is also this should also be in this direction. I'm sorry, I have drawn it wrongly. It should be in the positive direction because this will be in positive. So this will be something like this because since it has high loads acting here, you can see that the slope is very large, whereas here the slope is very less. Now if coming to the bending moment diagram, since I have low slope here, I can start like this, and here I have high slope. Then again, I continue to have high slope only. So let me assume that the beam ends here because I don't have space. It will become something like this. So let me draw it again. It will be like this and like this. So this will be a bending moment diagram for this kind of loading. Next question. Okay, so this is a cantilever beam. So let me take that the intensity is W and it is spread to a length of A. So since they both are in the same distance and have the same intensity, when I try to calculate my vertical force, that is my reaction at this support, it will come out to be zero because this effect will be nullified by this opposite effect. So my V is equal to zero. Only in this case I'm going to draw the diagram. So if my V is going to be zero, then at the end I'm going to have zero. So in the free end, obviously you'll have zero shear force only. So this means that here, since this is in the downward direction, I know the sign convention, it is negative. Therefore, it will become, and for a UDL, it is a linearly varying diagram. So it will become something like this. This will be my shear force diagram. Whereas when I come to my bending moment diagram, you can see that the moment caused by this load will be an anti-clockwise moment. So anti-clockwise is positive when we look from the right side. So since it causes an anti-clockwise moment, this will be positive. And since it is a UDL, it will be parabolic in nature. And then after coming to this point, there will be change in moment. And we can see that the moment caused by the load present in the free end will be larger than the moment or any counteracting moment placed nearer to the end. Therefore, we cannot tell that the bending moment will reduce after this. The bending moment will only keep on increasing. The bending moment will increase and it will reach this point. So I'm sorry, this looks very odd, your bending moment diagram. So next question. Oh, with this we come to the end of the video, and that is your 22 questions. So tell me how much you got correct out of 22. It is okay even if you got 10 out of 22 correct. We'll just keep on working. There are so many videos that are going to come that will make you well versed in the upcoming topics. So thank you so much for watching, guys. I'll see you in the next video. I hope this video was fun. It was really fun for me to do this video. Let me know what you thought of this video. I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye. See you. How much times did I tell videos in the last 5 seconds?